Just wave your hands to him and appreciate him. Thank him for life. Thank him for provision. Thank him for health. Thank him for sustenance. Our God is a good God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' name, we have worshiped. I want to thank the choir. They've made my job so easy. And they have confirmed the message that I want to preach this morning. I wasn't supposed to be here today. I was supposed to go to Ibadan to join the regional pastor for his send forth. But he sent a message and said, stay and preach. And this word came to me. And when the choir began to minister, everything I wanted to say, they were saying it. I want you to talk to God this morning. You are here to hear him speak to you. You are tired of listening to lies. You are tired of listening to yourself. This morning, you want to hear from the one that created you. The one that knows your ending from your beginning. The one who knows how you will succeed. The one who knows where you will fail. You want him to speak to you. So as you lift up your hands to God this morning, say, God, speak to me. I want to hear you. In this message, let your word come. I need your word. I need your word. Open my heart to receive your word. Let your word not fall to the ground void. Let your word prosper in my life. Let your word come into me. Let your word transform me. Let your word heal me. Let your word prosper me. Let your word put me on the road to success. Let your word shine light into my darkness. Your word. I need your word. I need your word this morning. Father, your word, your word, your word. And the second prayer, Lord, open my mouth to speak your word. As I receive your word, open my mouth to speak your word. It's not enough to receive. What you receive must come out. So, Lord, open my mouth to speak your word. Help me to speak your word to my situation. To speak your word to my circumstances. To speak your word to my life and to my future. In the name of Jesus. Father, we stand in expectation. We have not come to listen to man. We have come to listen to you. The creator of the heavens and the earth. The Almighty God. Lord, we ask this morning that your presence will fill this church. Speak to us. Use your servant to speak your word. For everyone who has come for this service, let your word not pass them by. We rebuke, O God, every distracting spirit. Every contrary spirit, we bind them in the name of Jesus. Let your word have free course. Let our hearts be opened to receive. And Lord, we pray that as we receive the ability to speak your word, grant to us. Let this service be life transforming. Thank you, Lord, our Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. Please be seated. God bless you. Let me welcome all those who are coming for the first time. It's my prayer that whatever it is you are believing God for, this month, you will receive it in the name of Jesus. And for those who brought them, those who invited them, let me also appreciate you. That's what evangelism is all about. That is what love of God is all about. Bringing people to your Father's house. I pray too that everything you want, God will give it to you in the name of Jesus. At the end of the service, we'll be giving you gifts. Those who came for the first time and those who brought them. So please don't rush away. This month is our month of prophecy. And the last time I ministered, I was trying to make you understand what prophecy means. This morning, I want to speak on the topic, speak the word only. If you are taking down notes, please take it down, because this is a message you will refer to often and often. Speak the word only. Amos chapter 3, verse 7. Amos chapter 3, verse 7. He says, surely the Lord God will do nothing, but he revealeth his secret unto his servants, the prophets. This verse tells you the relationship between God and man. God will not do anything without first revealing the secret to his servant, the prophets. I want you to understand that God cares so much for you that your future cannot happen without God revealing it to his servants, the prophets. From this verse, it means that prophecy is the secret of God revealed. Prophecy is the secret of God revealed. In another word, prophecy is the word of God concerning your future. The word of God concerning your future. And I tell you this, many of us, our biggest problem is that we have no idea of what the future looks like. The reason why you are confused, the reason why you are in darkness, is because you have no idea of how tomorrow will be. I know many of you, your mood will change. If I were to tell you, tomorrow I will give you 1 million naira, you will begin to jubilate, because you know that when you wake up, somebody you trust will give you 1 million. So many of us are depressed because we have no information, no idea of what tomorrow will bring. And the greatest source of prophecy is the Bible. The greatest source of God's secret is the Bible. And so when God had to advise Joshua after the death of Moses on how to make it, he said, be strong, be courageous. He said, but this book of the law, meditate upon it day and night, then thou shalt have good success. There is a place you can look at and the secrets will be revealed. Secrets belong to God. Deuteronomy 29 verse 29 said the secret things belong to God, but the things that are revealed, he said, they belong to us and our children forever. The Bible is the biggest and strongest source of prophecy. In fact, the Bible says anything that contradicts the scripture cannot be called a prophecy. So any prophet who stands to give you a prophecy that is contrary to the word of God is a fake prophet. Proverbs 18, verse 21. Proverbs 18, verse 21. Proverbs 18, verse 21. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. And they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. God, who gave us the Bible, is giving us a revelation. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. And they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. Whether you would live and whether you will die, and the life that you will live is dependent on what you say. And many people will say, how can? How can? A man was sharing in a book I wrote. His friend was dying. And the doctor called him and said, come and say farewell to your friend. Because all the tests we have done, they are very bad. The operation is a formality. I believe by the time he comes out of his theater, he will be a dead man. So, come and say farewell to him before the man departs. And he came there very sorrowful. And the nurses too, because they knew the report of the doctors, told him, sorry, we know he's very close to you, but we are sorry. There's nothing anybody can do about it. And as he held his friend's hand, confused, his friend, very weak, told him, don't worry. I will come out of the theater alive. He said he looked at this man and said, I wish he knew the report of the doctors. I wish he knew the report of the tests that have been done. He can't leave. So this man went in and he waited. And for hours, they were in the theater. And lo and behold, they came out. The man was alive. And he asked the doctor, the man is alive? He said, well, he has survived, but I don't know. But to cut a long story short, that man lived. And the doctor came back to him and said, let me confess to you, the only reason why this man is alive is because he was determined to be alive. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. A man stole. He was working in the bank. He stole money in the bank. He had been stealing from the bank. And one day, somebody came from the headquarters and announced himself as the auditor. He has been sent to audit the accounts. The man knew. The moment he heard auditor sent from the headquarters, he knew that somehow all his clever tricks have been discovered. And the man rushed away from the bank and he went home. And once he got home, he told his wife, I am dead. I am dead. I am dead. He went into the room. The wife didn't understand. 3 hours later, the bank officials came to the house to look for him. And the wife said, I don't know what is happening, but he's in the room. They opened the room, he was dead. He didn't poison himself. He didn't shoot himself. He said it, I am dead. I am dead. As he lay down, he died. Life and death are in the power of the tongue. And that's why this morning, I want to talk to you about the words that you speak. Numbers 14, verse 28. Numbers 14, verse 28. Numbers 14, verse 28. Say unto them, as truly as I live, saith the Lord, as you have spoken in my ears, so will I do to you. Say unto them, as truly as I live, saith the Lord, as you have spoken in my ears, so will I do to you. Many of you have never seen this scripture. Every word that you speak is taken seriously in heaven. As long as I live and God does not die, as you have spoken in my ear, so will I do to you. So what manifests is what you say. What happens to you is the result of your utterance. There are many people who in moments of helplessness have decreed, I am finished. The word has been spoken. It's finished. There are some husbands in moments of anger, I regret marrying my wife. Regret enters the marriage. It has been said, it cannot go back. Why is it so? John chapter 6. John chapter 6, verse 63. John 6, 63. Jesus said, it is the spirit that quickeneth. He said, the flesh profiteth not. He said, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. The strongest thing that you have is the words that come out of your mouth. The flesh is nothing. He said these words, they are spirit and they are life, which means your words, they come to life. Your words come to pass. And that is why you must be careful of every careless word you speak, because words are spirits. And they are life. They come to life. In Genesis chapter 2, verse 19. Genesis chapter 2, verse 19. And out of the ground, the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the air and brought them unto Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. Every animal on this earth was named by you. A monkey is called a monkey because God told man, give him a name. If man had decided to call a goat woman, today you would have been calling a goat woman. It's whatever name man mentioned that God honored. God did not give names to animals. He showed it to man and said, give it a name. And God said he wanted to see what name it would give. So whatever name man gave, that became the name. It tells you the power that man has. The power that woman has. The power that carelessly you use without knowing that you are using spirit and life. In Genesis 1:26. Let's see, look at Genesis. Genesis 1:26. Very popular place. Genesis 1:26. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness. And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over the cattle and over the earth and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. Many of you have not considered this scripture very seriously. Apart from God speaking, God said, let us make man in our image and in our likeness. Which means, let us make man like God. Let man have the kind of powers that God has. Many of us make the mistake of thinking that when God talks about creating man in his image and likeness, we are talking about our physical look. No, the flesh profited nothing. The flesh is nothing. The flesh is dust. The image and likeness that God was creating is the power, the function, the attributes of God. So God decreed it, let us make this man in our image and in our likeness. And what are the things that God does? In Genesis 1 verse 3, God saw darkness. And God said, let there be light. And there was light. He spoke and it came to pass. And that same God said, I want this man to be like me. What does that mean? Let him speak and it will come to pass. He saw darkness and said, let there be light. And there was light. And that same God created you in his image and likeness so that you too can tell darkness, let there be light, and there will be light. But many of us do not understand the purpose and the plan of God for our lives. Romans chapter 4, verse 17. As it is written, I have made thee a father of many nations, before whom he believed, even God, who had quickened the dead and called those things which be not as though they were. He called those things which be not as though they were. English translation. I have made you the father of many nations in the presence of the God in whom he believed, who gives life to the dead and calls into existence the things that do not exist. How? Words. He said, through words, I call into existence the things that do not exist. Through words, I speak to the earth. I speak to tomorrow. I speak to my circumstances. I speak to my finance to bring what I want, even though right now it does not exist. True words. With my mouth, I call into being what does not exist into existence with my mouth. Are you understanding what I'm saying? 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 10. Whoso desires to love life and see good days, let him keep his tongue from evil and his lips from speaking deceit. The roadmap to success, the roadmap to good life. Whoso desires to love life and see good days, let him keep his tongue from evil and his lips from speaking deceit. Very simple instruction, but many of us, we overlook it. He said the key to what you will be or what you will not be lies in what you say. You want a good life, then your tongue, watch it. Watch what you say. Be very careful of the utterances of your mouth. It will determine what happens to you. Psalm 50. Psalm 50. Psalm 50. Verse 19. You give your mouth free rein for evil, and your tongue frames deceit. Do you know what it means to frame deceit? You know what it means to frame a photograph? He said, because of the things you say, the frame of manifestation that you see that is your reality is what you have said. When you look at your life now, what do you see? What frame do you see? Oh, suffering, bad luck, problems, deliverance. He said that is the frame that your mouth brought forth. Everything that has happened to you is as a result of what your tongue framed. Your tongue has framed deceit. Acts chapter 14, Acts 14, verse 3. Acts of the Apostles, verse 3. So they remained for a long time, speaking boldly for the Lord, who bore witness to the word of his grace, granting signs and wonders to be done by their hands. What happened? They were speaking God's word. They were speaking boldly of God's word. God bore witness that these words were from scripture, the words of his grace. And so what happened? Wonders, signs manifested through their hands. The moment they spoke God's word, God made them a sign and a wonder. God bore witness that the words they were repeating were words that he uttered, prophecies. And so God gave effect to them. So when he says, according to thy word, be healed, God said, it is written, it is true. Bow. When Jesus had to confront the devil, every time he reminded him, it is written. The moment he wrote, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, the heavens came forward. During that period of temptation, he was left alone. God left him to go into the wilderness. But every time he said, it is written, the angels came down because he was attesting to the word of God. I'm not speaking my words. These are prophecies concerning my future. It is written. And immediately, the heavens came down. Matthew 17, 20. Now listen to this. Matthew 17, verse 20. He said to them, because of your little faith, for truly I say to you, if you have faith like a grain of mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you. Jesus was trying to tell the apostles the secrets of the power of words. He said, but you don't believe, and what you don't believe will not come to pass. But if you believed, you will speak with authority to this mountain to move, and that mountain will move. But you don't believe. You don't believe that you have the power to speak and it will come to pass. Brethren, you can prophesy your future. You can use your words to create your future. Champions speak to their mountains. Losers talk about their mountains. There's a difference between speaking to problems and talking about problems. A man who is speaking to his problem is telling that problem, you cannot destroy me. You can't intimidate me, you will go. But the man who is talking about his problem is a man saying, this problem has killed me. And because that is his utterance, he will die of that problem. In the same Matthew 16, look at Matthew 16. Matthew 16, verse 19. Matthew 16, verse 19. Jesus told Peter, he said, I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. But Peter didn't understand. He was still afraid. He took the Holy Ghost coming upon him for the spirit of Peter to disappear. and for boldness to come into his mouth. He said, whatever you bind, the heavens will bind it. Whatever you lose, the heavens will lose it. And who is greater, the heavens or the earth? But he didn't understand. And many of us, God looks at us. Power has been given unto you, but you have chosen to be a weakling. The devil is supposed to be under you, but you are serving him as your master. Why? Ignorance. My people perish for lack of knowledge. Mark 11, verse 23. Truly I say unto you, whoever says to this mountain, be taken up and thrown into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that what he says will come to pass, it will be done for him. Believes that what he says will come to pass, it will be done for him. Don't worry about who will do it. The Bible did not say you will do it. He said it will be done for him. All that is important is that believe and say it. It will be done for you. Believe and say it. Where's a spirit and their life? In Joshua chapter 6, verse 26. Joshua spoke and said, Joshua laid an oath on them at that time, saying, cursed before the Lord be the man who rise up and rebuild the city Jericho. At the cost of his firstborn shall he lay his foundation, and at the cost of his youngest son shall he set up his gates. A man spoke. Joshua was a man like you and I. He spoke. Whoever will lay this foundation, his first son will die. As he's trying to complete, his last son will die. What happened? Look at 1 Kings. 1 Kings chapter 16, verse 34. In his days, he had a better beauty Jericho. He laid his foundation at the cost of Abraham, his firstborn, and set up his gates at the cost of his youngest son, Segob, according to the word of the Lord, which is spake by Joshua, the son of Nun. A man spoke years ago. Anybody that would attempt to build this place, his firstborn will die. Years later, it happened. And why did God say according to him? Any man who exercises the power that God has freely conferred on us, it's exercising the will of God. When you speak in accordance with God's word, you are speaking God's word. Joel chapter 3, verse 10. Beat your plowshares into swords, and your pruning hooks into spears. Let the weak say, I am strong. Is that a lie? Some people say it's a lie. No! He said the weakness that you have is an imagination. The enemy is trying to weaken you by the weakness you are experiencing. So speak to your weakness and say, I'm strong. Don't accept the weakness, because that is an imagination of the enemy. When Jesus was saying that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, the rulers of the darkness of this world, wickedness in high places, the next verse shocked me. He said, casting down imagination. Imagination. The word of God says, what do you imagine against the Lord. He said the Lord will put an utter end to it. Affliction will not rise up a second time. Imagination. Let the weak say I'm strong. Because the plan of God for your life is not that you are weak. You are strong. Do you know how God made you? You were beautifully made. In the image and in the likeness of God. You had dominion. How can you be weak? Let the weak say I'm strong. Any battle you enter believing you are weak, you will die. Let the weak say I'm strong. When David confronted Goliath, any normal person would have been afraid. King Saul was afraid. David's elder brothers, they were afraid. Because when they looked at the giant, they said, no, this one is too strong for us. But David remembered, I come in the name of the living God. I cannot be weak. I am strong. I am stronger than you. I am stronger than you. I will kill you. He spoke, and God did it. Goliath was killed. Let the weak say, I am strong. Your confessions are too negative. My brother, how is life? Oh boy, terrible. What good can come out of a confession that says life is terrible? Are you okay? Ah, no, I'm not okay at all. How can you be okay when you have said you are not okay at all? Your children nowadays are useless. They go even worse past me. Careless words, but words that will come to life. You are framing the picture of your family for the future. Isaiah 33, verse 24. And no inhabitant will say, I am sick. The people who dwell there will be forgiven their iniquity. But listen to this. And no inhabitant will say, I am sick. Don't say it. It's a negative pronouncement. The devil is waiting for it. The moment you say it, sickness will invade you. Let no inhabitant say, I am sick. Don't say it. Even if the doctor says you are sick, confess you are strong, you are well. Because what does God say? How can God wish above all things that you prosper, be in health, even as your soul prospers, and a man tells you you are sick? When you know that by his stripes you were healed, when you know that he has promised that the disease of Egypt will not be cast upon you, how can you disbelieve his word? Let not the inhabitants say, I am sick. Because when you say it, you give life to it. Hebrews 13. We'll begin to close. Hebrews 13. Hebrews 13. Reading from verse 5. Keep your life free from love of money. And be content with what you have, for he has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So we can confidently say, the Lord is my helper. I will not fear what man can do to me. I want you to look at the revelation in these two verses. I am content because he has said. The reason for my confidence is that he has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So because of that, I can confidently say with my own mouth, the Lord is my helper. I will not fear what man can do for me. Do you see the connection between the two? Because he has said, I can confidently say. Because he has said, I will be the head. I can confidently say, I am the head. Because he has said, I will not be sick. I can confidently say, I am well. Do you understand what I am saying? Because he has said, I can confidently say, prophecy, begin it to life. God has spoken, and because of that, I can say, the words that I speak are not my words. I speak the words of God concerning my life. God has said, I will be rich, so I'm saying, I am rich. Understand prophecy. You are small because you talk small. You are weak because you say you are weak. What has God said? Because of what God has said, I can confidently say that is well. I don't know whether you understand what I'm saying. And let me tell you this. No word is idle. The dangerous thing that I want you to know is that every word that you speak is recorded. Every word that you speak is recorded. How do I know? Matthew 12. Matthew chapter 12. Verse 36. I tell you, on the day of judgment, people will give account for every careless word they speak. People will give account for every, not some, not the, for every careless word they speak. For by your words, you will be justified, and by your words, you will be condemned. Every word you speak from your mouth is recorded. Why? Because words are powerful. Words are powerful. The power that you have, that animals do not have, is the authority in your word. Every word you speak is being recorded. So you cannot say, oh, I didn't know what I was saying. No, you said it. It will be played back to you. Every careless word is recorded. Everything you said is being recorded. Psalm 107. Psalm 107. Oh, give thanks to the Lord for his good. For his steadfast love endureth forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he has redeemed from trouble. You know, many of us do not know how to thank God. There are many of you who have never given testimonies. But yeah, he said, let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he had redeemed from the hand of the enemy. Say so. Let your mouth proclaim the power of God in your life. Let your mouth express your gratitude for waking up from sleep. Let your mouth acknowledge that you traveled and came back because God was with you. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he had redeemed. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. That's why in Revelation 12:1, he said they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. How did they overcome? Not just by pleading the blood of Jesus alone and the word of their testimony. What word did they speak? Your words make you to overcome. I overcame sickness by the word. I overcame poverty by the word. When I tell you, I can never be poor. I can never be broke. Some people might think I'm boasting. But I'm confessing. Because I know that what I confess would always come to pass. I cannot say I will never be broke and be broke. I cannot say poverty is my servant and poverty will become my master. Because I know that what I say that comes to pass. So I'm not going to impress anybody by giving myself an image I do not want.
No.
I am rich. I am very rich. And every time I confess it, money comes. He said, just say it and believe it, and it will be done. Forget about how it will be done, but it will be done. That is the spirit working. It will be done. Forget about how, but it will be done. But you say it and believe it. So you overcome situations by the words that you speak, because death and life are in the power of the tongue. Let's close. Jeremiah, verse 23. Jeremiah 23. Verse 29. Is not my word like as a fire, saith the Lord, and like a hammer that breaketh the rock in pieces? Therefore, behold, I'm against the prophets, saith the Lord, that shield my words, every one from his neighbor. Behold, I'm against the prophets, saith the Lord, that use their tongues and say, he saith. That use their tongue and say, he saith. Not that say it, but that use their tongues and say it, he said, behold, I'm against them that prophesy false dreams, saith the Lord. And do tell them, and cause my people to err by their lies and by their lightness. Yet I send them not, neither commanded them. Therefore they shall not profit these people at all, saith the Lord. Brethren, there are a lot of false prophets. They capitalize on your refusal to be close to God. And so they tell you things that suit your present situation and not what God wants you to do. They extort you and they make your situation worse. Instead of you to go closer to God himself, take his book, meditate on it. Know his words concerning you. You allow charlatans to tell you things that are contrary to the word of God. But the good thing, the same Psalm 107 verse 20, God said, I sent my word, and I healed them, and I delivered them from their destruction. What did he send? My word. I sent my word. And what did the word do? To heal, to deliver from destruction. Word. Many of you are looking for something bigger than words, but you are forgetting that what you see on the earth was created by words. Words. And the one who created by words also said, you will be like me. You will be like me. Speak and it will come to pass. But believe in what you say and I will do it. But we have said, no, that's not possible. That's too hard. John chapter 1. John chapter 1, verse 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made, the Word. In him was life, and the light was the light of men, the word. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not, the word. Verse 10 of that same verse. He was in the word, and the word was made by him, and the word knew him not, the word. He came into his own, and his own received him not, the word. But as many as received him, the word, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name,
which were born
not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And in verse 14, and the word was made flesh. The word is spirit and life. It comes to pass. It became flesh. It manifested. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. The words you speak will begin to dwell among you. The poverty you spoke about, you will begin to see it. The sickness, you will begin to see. The defeat, you will begin to see. It dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory. The glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Why come it's so difficult to comprehend the power of the word? Bow down your heads in prayers. Bow down your heads in prayers. Speak the word only. Bow down your heads in prayers. Bow down your heads in prayers. I don't know whether God has ministered to you. I don't know whether God has spoken to you. The Bible talks about the time in the days of Eli the prophet, the word of God was scarce. Why? Because of sin. Eli and his children polluted the altar of God, and so God stopped to speak. No more prophecy, no more vision, no more revelation. God kept quiet. Are you here this morning? God is not speaking to you. Any man that God is not speaking to is in darkness, because you are going through life without direction. The words of God, they are a lamp unto our feet. They are a light to our lives. The word of God. Except you truly believe and confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, you will find out that your words will have no effect. Your words will have no effect. The heavens must recognize you. God must recognize you. Your mouth will have authority only when that mouth confesses. Lord, I am sorry for my sins. Forgive me. I accept your son Jesus as my Lord and personal Savior. Come into my life. Come and help me. Strengthen me. Then you will see a turnaround. You will see God take control of your life. And then God will begin to open chapters for you. You will begin to mature in Christ. Till the day when you will realize that anything you want, all you need to do is to say it. Say it. Speak it, and it will come to pass. Are you here this morning? You want to make your peace with God. You want to have a better relationship with God. You want Jesus to become your Lord and personal Savior. You are tired of being on your own. You want God to help you. Lift up your hand. Let me pray for you. Just lift up your hand wherever you are. God bless you, my brother. God bless you. God bless you. Lift up your hand wherever you are. Lift up your hand. I want to pray for you this morning. I want to pray for you. Please come. Stand up. I want to pray for you. God bless you. Come. If you want to come, come quickly. Let me pray for you this morning. It's not enough to hear this message and just remain where you are. The only way the message can profit you is if you add faith. You move. Stand up and say, God, I accept you. Father, Lord, I want to thank you for these your sons who have heard your word. Your word has profited them. And Lord, they are asking this morning that you accept them. Erase their names from the book of death Write their names in the book of life. Let the spirit of adoption come upon them. Let them be able to cry to you. And Lord, answer them. From today, oh God, I ask that the power and authority you have given to those in Christ, you will give it to them. They will not go back into Egypt. They will no longer be servants to sin. From today, the power to overcome, you will give to them. Thank you for their lives. Bless them, oh God, in Jesus' name. Please, you just follow. You want to take your names down? I want to take your names down quickly. We want to pray. But before we pray, 1 Peter 4:11. 1 Peter 4:11. If any man speak, let him speak as the oracle of God. If any man speak, let him speak as the oracle of God. Be conscious of the words that you speak. Speak the words of God. Let your words be commandments. Let your words carry power and authority. Don't speak carelessly. Don't embrace your imagination. Don't romance your weakness. Speak as the oracle of God. What has God said concerning your life? Speak in accordance with God's word. Speak with power. Speak with authority. The evangelism people were speaking this morning, and they referred to Psalm 35, verse 27. Let the Lord be glorified, who takes delight in the prosperity of his servants. Let the Lord be glorified, who takes delight in the prosperity of his servant. God is happy when you prosper. God wants to brag about you. When you are poor, you are wretched, you make God a liar. Because that is not the plan for you. I know the thoughts I have towards you. They are thoughts of good and not of evil, to lead you to an expected end. Speak as the oracle of God. Please stand up for prayers. Stand up for prayers. I want you to pray to God to open your mouth to speak. There is nobody that can decree your destiny. God has given you power to speak. Death and life are in the power of your tongue. Speak. Because of time, I will just take one or two prayer points. Isaiah chapter 3, verse 10. Isaiah 3, verse 10. Listen to me. This is a prophecy which God gave to the prophet Isaiah. He said, say ye to the righteous that they shall be well with him, for they shall eat the fruit of their doings. Nobody said amen. Listen carefully. God who gave us 2 years did it deliberately. So that if one misses the second one, we take it. Listen carefully. This is the month of prophecy. And I'm telling you, speak the word only. What is the word? The secrets of your life. The word of God concerning your life. It cannot fail. And this is what Isaiah the prophet recorded. Say ye to the righteous that it shall be well with him. I didn't hear amen. Yeah. For they shall eat the fruit of their doings. Yeah. Brethren, you are going to do me a favor. You will pray for yourself, but hold somebody first. Because this is a message that God wants you to communicate to somebody in church. He wants you to communicate that message. He said you should say to him with your mouth that it shall be well with him. What it means is that God is saying every part of you, it shall be well. It shall be well with your wife and your husband. It shall be well with your children. It shall be well with your parents. It shall be well with your business. It shall be well with your expectations. Your tomorrow shall be all right. So please, you are going to look at the person and you are going to speak to him as a prophet of God. How are you a prophet of God? You are speaking God's word. He says, say ye to the righteous, it shall be well with him. Please decree that word so it can dissolve every imagination the enemy has brought in by negative circumstances. God did not say it will not be well with you. He said it shall be well. And whatever God says must come to pass. So please hold that person. Look at the person in the eyes and say, I prophesy in the name of God, according to his word, that from today it shall be well with you. Every area of your life, it shall be well with you. Please pray for him. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. You know, some people, they don't know how to pray for others. So I don't want a situation where somebody will be cheating you. You are praying for him, but he's not praying for you. All he's just saying is amen, 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 amen. So put your hands on your head and decree as a prophet of God. Repeat after me, as a prophet of God. In accordance with his word, I decree today that from henceforth it shall be well with me, from my head to the sole of my feet, my family, my home, my business, my tomorrow, it shall be well. Pray for yourself. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, I'm going to read this prophecy. And as I read it, all I expect from you is amen and amen. And then when I close, any particular area of it, you can emphasize it in prayers. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy to your life. As many as are standing, hearing the sound of my voice, according to God's word, in Isaiah 65 verse 17, I decree that from today, this word of God will come true in your life. For behold, I create new heavens and a new earth. And the former shall not be remembered nor come into mind. Be ye glad and rejoice forever in that which I create. For behold, I create Jerusalem and rejoice and her people a joy. And I will rejoice in Jerusalem and joy in my people. And the voice of weeping shall be no more, nor the voice of crying. There shall be no more tears and infant of days, nor an old man that not feel these days. Which means nobody will die prematurely. Our children will not die. We will not bury our children. For the child shall die 100 years old. But the sinner being 100 years old shall be accused. You shall build houses and inhabit them. You shall plant vineyards and eat the fruit therein. You will not build and that will inhabit. You will not plant and that will eat. For as the days of a tree, so are the days of our people. And my elect shall enjoy the works of their hands. You will not labor in vain, nor bring forth for trouble. For you are the seed of the blessed of the Lord. And it shall come to pass that before you call, God will answer. When you are speaking, God will hear you. It will be so in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Listen to me. One last prayer point, because the enemy is like Pharaoh. He will attempt to pursue and pursue. So in Isaiah 8, verse 10, in case the enemy tries to do what you have learned, hear the word of God. God told them, he said, take counsel together, it shall come to naught. Speak the word and it shall not stand, for God is with us. What God is saying, as from today, every conspiracy against you shall come to naught. No matter what they speak, it will not stand. Why? God is with you. Tell yourself, God is with you. He said, for God is with us. The reason why he cannot stand, not that words are not powerful. He said, speak the word, it shall not stand. For God is with us. Because God is with us, their words will not stand. Tell yourself, because God is with me, no negative word will stand. No curse, no divination, no imagination will stand against me in the name of Jesus. I am what God says I am. I am what God says I am. I am a winner and not a loser. I am what God says I am. Say you are poor? Did God say you are poor? Did God say you are weak? So jump up and say, I'm a winner! And let me tell you, please, begin to speak to yourself. Especially to your children. Just carry your child and put your hand on his head. Say, my son, you'll be greater than me. You are going to bless my life. You will live to see your children. You will not die young. You will not marry a bad wife. You will excel in everything you do. Repeat it, repeat it, repeat it. It will come to pass in the life of the child. Telling you the truth. Our fathers tampered with our destiny by the things they said. They tampered with our destiny in anger. They gave us useless names, abused us, said all kinds of things about us, and those things have been working against us. It has taken the grace of Christ for us to fight those things. Don't make that same mistake. Prophesy to the lives of your children. Lay your hand and tell that child what you want. Wake up in the morning, go and bring my child. Put your hand on him and tell him what you want. You will be greater than him. You will succeed. There will not be no delay in your life. Everything that you need will come speedily. Pray for him. It will come to pass. Your tongue will make it come. And then change your own confession. Don't allow the devil to make you weep. He said they should not say that they are sick. Let the weak say, I'm strong. You will find a turnaround. I'm looking forward to testimonies. I used to be poor, now I'm rich. I was weak, now I'm strong. Testimonies. Do I have witnesses in the house of testimonies? Amen. God bless you. Please be seated.